champion, Amy's Ice Creams, Austin, Texas. Amy's Ice Cream started playing the great game of business in 2006. Over the years, they've seen some pretty impressive results. They managed to grow their net income by 250%. They created multiple income sources and developed their own training company. But the one thing they're most proud of is their people. They've taught everyone financial literacy, and by doing so, the team is more confident about business and even their own financial goals. Initially, leadership was met with pushback, but as the team started seeing positive results, they realized they really could impact the company's success. So much so, that they vowed to never cancel a huddle. Consistent huddling and multiple mini games helped to boost sales and increase positive feedback from their customers. The team at Amy's Ice Creams understands the game isn't just about the numbers. It's about educating everyone and showing them they really can make a difference. Congratulations, All-Star Champion, Amy's Ice Creams.
Thank you so much. I want to thank Jack, the committee. Unfortunately, Amy couldn't be here. She had a very personal commitment that she had to adhere to. In the spirit of steward leadership, she entrusted Aaron and myself to say thank you in the event that we won. So thank you. There's only a few of us up here on the stage, but we're missing quite a few. Around about 267 of us are missing up here. Those are the individuals that actually made all of this happen. We have an internal Facebook group, so we've got them live right now. truly, that team should be here on the stage. The stage should be filled with 16 and 17 and 22 and 32 and 45-year-olds, because we're all one big happy family. And again, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
I also want to tell you a little bit about my personal story with Open Book Management, more importantly, the great game of business. You see, I'm a dyslexic guy. I grew up that way, and I was told I'll never be good at math because I can't define myself. So I thought numbers were never going to be my game. And so, when I was in business, doing marketing, working for different companies, I never knew the real measures of success, and I never knew how to affect the numbers. It's when I went to Amy's Ice Creams to be their marketing director that I found I don't have to know math inside my head. I can use a calculator. And more importantly, spreadsheets. But you see, on my first huddle, 2 weeks in, Amy looked at me in front of the entire company and said, "Aaron, how are we going to increase sales?" I was floored. I thought, I have no idea. I just got here. And then it came to me. It's about our people. That is going to increase sales. It's about amazing flavors and an amazing product and experience you can't get anywhere else. And it was that that I realized, it was then that I realized, if we can get every single person in our company to think like owners, to not just think like a marketing director, but to truly think like owners, we are going to see financial results that are unparalleled. And as you saw on our video, 250% over 10 years. That beats the industry average by a long shot. In fact, if you hear from most of our ice cream competitors, they are noticing a decrease in sales on regular ice creams. But we stay on top of that trend, and we are seeing an increase in sales for our ice cream, beating the industry trend. But for me personally, I was finally connected to something larger, and I have the financial data, and I have the know-how to make great strides, not for myself, but for the entire organization. And it let me know something. It let me know that there is something bigger for all of us out there. And I'll even say, this great nation, there's something bigger that every business can do. So when you're out there in the community and people just don't understand what the great game of business is, You tell them it starts with people, and that you give them the measures of success, and they will go far beyond anything you've ever done before. And that's how we're going to save America. That's how we're going to save the middle class. We are going to make exceptionalism our number one priority. And you do that by knowing the rules and teaching the rules, following the action and keeping score, and most importantly, sharing the success. There's a reason we say that over and over and over again. It's because it works, it works, it works. And I want you all to take that very personally, because this is what's going to lead our great nation forward. This is what's going to lead your own businesses going forward. There's something very special that's a part of the great game of business. And if you haven't found it yet, just keep searching. Come and find me, I'll tell you all about it. Come find this guy. Give us a little something about it. And more importantly, seek change. Seek change in the way your employees embrace the great game of business. Seek change in the way that you interact in the community. For us, we want to see three things happen. Great quality of life for our employees, amazing health of the business, and a community that stands strong because they have a basis for financial literacy and they have a basis to see their own success through personal finance. I can't thank everybody at the Great Game enough. I also want to thank our friends at Zing Train. They've also helped us out quite a bit. And I want every one of you to shake the hand of the person next to you, because that is your key to success. And I truly believe in that key. I truly believe we can achieve that success. Thank you, yes. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. We are so pleased to accept this award. We are going to put this in our absolute favorite trophy case and have all the light shine on it so everybody knows that we're still on our journey. It never is going to end. But I can tell you, great things lie ahead. Thank you so much.
Two of the nuggets that I picked out of their day-to-day living is, one is their slogan is make people's days. How can energy be more brighter than trying to make somebody's day every day? And then obviously playing a fundamental role in rebuilding the middle class. This is one of their action items in almost every single one of their stores. And they do this by one simple philosophy, and that is that when their kids leave, they leave with an understanding of business literacy, leadership skills, and the ability to plan critically for the future. What a gift these guys give our kids. Please give them a round of applause.